Hello friends, and welcome back to my channel. So in this particular video, I'm going to cover the next set of questions which people frequently asks me. So I thought it is a good idea to answer them through a video in a centralized platform rather than accommodating such questions personally, because I see that it is being asked by multiple people. So already there is a volume 1 which has covered 10 very basic questions or 10 most frequently asked questions by NAATI aspirants. So I'm just coming up with another video, and as and when I find such questions which are repeating by people, so I'll keep on posting such videos so that it helps you in your NAATI journey, and you do not need to wait for my reply or anyone else, and you can get everything answered through a video itself. So without any further delay, let's begin with the question sets. So the first question in this video is like, how many days before the exam date will I receive the invite for test? What should I do if I haven't received it till a day before the exam? Okay, this is a very interesting question actually. So ideally, if you are not aware of, or if you are, so a few days before your exam, you will be receiving a final invite which will even have the link, okay, to use while connecting for the exam. So it is a Microsoft Teams link that they provide to you. So ideally, you should be receiving such emails a week before the exam date, okay, but we have encountered many cases wherein people have not received it even a day before the exam. So no need to be tensed about it. The only responsibility from your side is to drop them an email just asking that, okay, I have my exam on so and so date and I haven't received the invite till now, so when can I expect it? As simple as that. That is your duty, so you should do it. Okay, apart from that, it has happened for some people that they received 1 hour before the exam. So just be assured that you will receive the invite and your exam will happen. So don't think that if you haven't received the invite even a few days before, even a day before the exam, that it is not, that the exam might be postponed. No, it is not going to happen. They will connect at the particular time whatever you have chosen for your exam. Okay, so I think I have made myself clear here. So your exam will happen. Ideally, you should receive 1 week before the exam. If not, drop them an email. Okay, they are very responsive. Of course, they will reply. Okay, but they might take time because they have to accommodate many such requests. Okay, and just be ready for the exam as per your test date and test time. Okay, and it will happen for sure. What should I do if I haven't received it? So as I said that, okay, if you haven't received it, just drop them an email. Okay, they will surely reply to it, and make sure to connect for the exam because it will happen. They will do it for sure. Okay, many people have received it. Some people have received it an hour before the exam, so of course it will happen. It is never going to happen that they are just directly going to cancel your exam without even letting you know. It's not going to happen like that. They will answer it. I mean, your exam will be there for sure. So the next question: what do I need to have handy before appearing for the exam? Are there any checks performed before the exam? Okay, again, a very interesting question and very frequently asked. What do you need to keep handy? So of course, for the exam, you need your passport to be there, because there are three types of checks which are performed before you start your exam. The first check is your ID check, your identity check, wherein they will request you to show your passport or your Australian driving license if you have, okay, and they are going to verify your identity that, okay, you are the person who should be appearing for the exam. The second check will be a room check, wherein they will ask you to rotate your camera just to make sure that you are alone in the room, and also you do not have anything handy with you which might help you during the exam, or it's unethical. Okay, maybe some preparation materials, they'll ask you to just keep it somewhere else and not to keep it besides you. The third check will be a notepad check, wherein they will ask you to show your notepad just to make sure that it is empty. Okay, so you need to have a notepad to take notes. So I'll come to those questions too. So these are the few things that you should have. So of course, you should have your passport. That is a must. If you don't have a passport, they will cancel your exam. Okay, So I have covered the checks. Now coming to, like, apart from your passport, you should also have a earphone or headphone, whatever you're comfortable with. You should have that to connect for the exam. And you should also have a laptop or an iPad or tablet or something like that. Okay. Mobile phones are not allowed. They will ask you to switch it off. So the best way is to keep a laptop or a desktop or anything. I mean, laptop or desktop, whatever you're comfortable with. So you need to have all these things handy. Okay, do we need to install Microsoft Teams before the exam? So as I've already mentioned that the exams are conducted on Microsoft Teams app. Okay, so it is not necessary for you to install the Microsoft Teams. Okay, if you have it installed, then well and good, but it is not necessary. If you don't have Microsoft Teams installed on your exam, and if you click on the link that is provided by them, okay, then it is going to open the web version of it, and even you can use that. It will ask you to just give a name. Okay, so you just provide your name whenever it asks for your name, and then you can directly use the web version and give it for and use it for giving the exam. No need to have it installed, but if you have it installed, it's good. But it's not a mandate that you need to have it installed. Okay, you can even use the web version, and whenever you click on the link, it actually redirects you to the web version if you don't have Microsoft Teams installed. Okay, so another very frequently used asked question is, can I take the notes on my laptop? Okay, if not, then what can I use to take notes? Can I use a notepad, or do I need to use only sheets of paper? Should I use a pen, or can I use a pencil too? Okay, so many such questions regarding notes taking. So I have just clubbed it into one. So can I take the notes on my laptop? No, you are not supposed to take notes on your laptop. Laptop is only for you to connect to the exam using Microsoft Teams and nothing else. Okay, and then where can I take notes? So you can either use a notepad, or you can use loose sheets of paper. I usually recommend people to use loose sheets of paper, because supposedly you hear an introductory statement and you need to keep it handy throughout your course of your exam, because you might have some names over there and you don't want to write it while taking notes again and again. So you can just write it on a sheet of paper and just keep it handy besides you. But if you have a notepad, then again, you need to just keep on flipping it just to check what was the name that was initially spoken, or what was the introductory statement. So if you just have loose sheets of paper, it is more flexible. You can use it more properly. So I recommend people to use loose sheets of paper, A4 sheets of paper, rather than using a notepad. But if you are comfortable using a notepad, you can do that. Okay. So I've answered that also. Okay. Should I use a pen or a pencil? So that is entirely your choice. You can use whatever you are comfortable with. It's just that you should write something and you should be able to read it. That's it. You should not use your laptop for taking notes. Laptop is only for connecting to the exam, nothing else. What will happen if I face some technical issues during the exam? Very genuine question, okay? And it is there in most of the people's minds, what is going to happen, or what should I do if I face some technical issues? Okay, so first of all, let me just tell you how the exam is conducted. Okay, so before starting your exam, the examiner is going to play a portion of the dialogue just to make sure that you are able to hear it properly. Okay, only then, after this check is performed, they are going to start your exam. So if you are facing any issues with respect to hearing the audio properly, you can just bring it to their concern, saying that, okay, I am not able to hear it properly. They will try to find some solution for it. If they are not able to, then they are going to postpone your exam, saying that, okay, maybe today we are facing some connectivity issues. They are going to give you a new date, maybe a week after or a 2 week after, but surely within 2 weeks you will have a new date. It can even happen, depending upon the availability of the dates, it can also be that you may get a date 2 to 3 days after your previous date, but maximum within 2 weeks you will surely get a date, and then you can appear for the exam if you face any issues with respect to technical issues with respect to hearing. Now, if you face some connectivity issues during the exam, so with respect to connectivity issues, supposedly, okay, there is a power cut and your Wi-Fi is not working, so you got disconnected from the exam. So they are going to reach you via your phone number or your email. Okay, they are going to do that. So you can just let them know that, okay, there was a power cut because of which my connection got lost, and they are, and whenever it is back, they are of course going to accommodate that, or they are going to give you another date where you can take up the exam again. So no need to worry if regarding technical issues. You can of course, I mean, just let them know that okay, it was a technical issue that I was facing, and they will surely accommodate it. If but of course you cannot misuse it, okay, and you should not misuse it, okay. Only if there is a power cut or something. So you should also have a backup in terms of maybe a dongle or something, okay, just to make sure that okay, even if Wi-Fi is turned off or it gets disconnected, you are still able to connect to the exam, okay. So because no one wants to have their exams postponed or take it on a later date, because it just adds to the pressure. So I'll recommend you to have a backup, a dongle or something, okay. Okay, the next question is, I have currently booked my exam with LOTE. LOTE is another language other than English as Hindi. Can I change it to Punjabi, Telugu, Tamil or any other language? And what is the way to do it? Okay, NAATI has given you this feature wherein you can change your language, your LOTE, language other than English, to any other language that you want. Supposedly, initially you went for Hindi, and then nowadays, I mean, a few weeks back, we got information that now Telugu is also available and people can actually take the test in the what many people did is that they sent an email to NAATI saying that okay, we want to change the language, and then NAATI happily accepted it, and they always do that. So you are supposed to send them an email saying that okay, I want to change my language from this particular language to that to whatever your choice is, and they will do it, and it can only happen by sending an email. There is no feature in the website or anywhere else which will allow you to change your language directly. Only if you drop them an email, okay, they will accept it, and they are then going to change the language and give you a different date for the exam, whatever is the available date. So of course, if you're changing the language, it may happen that your exam may be postponed depending upon the availability of your chosen language. Okay, so it can only be done by sending an email. There is no other way of doing it. Okay, and of course you have the option of doing it, of changing your LOT to any language that you prefer. Okay, next question. Can I use my phone to give the exam, or can I use phone to take notes? Okay, many people have the habit because they are very good at typing that they think that okay, maybe we can use some note section in the phone to take notes, because they usually are it's very handy and people are accustomed to typing very fast on their phones. But yeah, they won't allow you to take notes on your phone. And what they make sure is that they will ask you to turn off your phone before the exam, okay. And they will make sure that you do that. So of course you cannot use your phone either for taking notes or for a hotspot connection or anything else. They will ask you to turn it off, and you are supposed to do it. And if you just turn it on, it may be a distraction during the exam also. So I also recommend you to kindly turn it off. Focus only on the exam at hand, and not to practice any unethical things during the exam, because it will just create a problem for you. Okay. So the next question is, the time specified in the email is Indian Standard Time or Australian? How do I find out my time zone? Okay, very, very, very frequently asked question. Okay, so whenever you book your exam, right? So it is always Australian time. Even the NAATI website, it shows that it is Australian time. Okay, so I mean, don't think that it is Indian Standard Time, and don't connect, because if you connect using the Indian Standard Time, then it may happen that your exam time has already passed. So what can you do? Because sometimes you're confused as to whether it is an Indian Standard Time or Australian. So it is Australian, and just to confirm, because in India we follow a single time zone, but in Australia there are different time zones that are available. So as soon as you receive an email, you can just drop them an email asking that okay, what will be the Indian Standard Time of it, or what will be a local time. Okay, they will surely give you a reply saying that this is when you're supposed to join the exam, and this is the time that you should do it. They are going to do that. Okay, so even you can open your email on a Google email, and it will show you on a browser, and it will show you your time zone. But I would prefer you, okay, that you send them an email and confirm that what particular time zone that you need to follow or what will be the time in IST for connecting to the exam. They always accommodate such requests and they reply. So make sure that you use that instead of following whatever is mentioned on the web or somewhere else. Okay, it's better to confirm directly from the source rather than following something else. Okay. So even if it's because mostly people use Gmail, Gmail also gives you a feature wherein it tells you whether it's IST or AEST. AEST is Australian Eastern Standard Time. It tells you that. Okay. So but anyways, I always prefer people to or recommend people to send them an email and they are going to reply you with the correct time zone. Okay. Do we need to use headphones or earphones? If yes, then are there any specifications like it is there for PTE? Okay, so you can use whatever you like. It's just that, okay, it can be a headphone or an earphone, whatever you like. It's just that it should enable you to listen to the recording. That's it. Why you should not? You can even think that, okay, maybe I don't use anything. But what will happen is that because of your surrounding noises, it may happen that you may miss out on some important information in the dialogues. And it can hamper your scores. So always better to use a device which may be either a headphone or an earphone. It's totally depend upon whatever your choice is. There are no specifications, and I would prefer or I would recommend people not to waste any money on buying a particular headset or a headphone or a earphone for this particular exam. This exam you can use even your mobile headphones, mobile earphones, or any headphones that you have, whatever you are comfortable with, okay, or you have been using. Okay, just use that. Don't waste your money on buying something new for this exam, because this exam is very short. It is only for 15 minutes, and moreover, they are going to verify whether they are able to hear you or not. If they are not able to hear you, they are going to tell you that, okay, we are not able to hear you. Okay, so then we can do something. But no specification as such, you don't require. And most of the people who are giving the exam, they are using a normal earphone or headphone. They are not buying anything new, and I don't recommend people also to buy, because there are no such specification. Okay, nowadays people who have their test booked on 1st September or 1st of October are receiving emails about choosing another date. So the first question is it genuine? Okay, or are those email fake? Okay, or why are we getting such emails? What should we do? Okay, many people nowadays are posting it, and it has started happening with people who have their test books on 1st of September. Many people have received such email saying that, okay, what are we supposed to do, and is it a genuine email from NAATI? Okay, so of course, if you see the email address, okay, it clearly says info@naati.com.au. It can be NSW also, something, depending upon whatever location that you initially selected for your online test. So it is a genuine email, and many people are actually getting it. Okay, another way or why are you getting it? It's simple that, okay, if you scroll down and after the location, there is also a note section on your email which says that this test will be conducted online during the following month, and exact date and specific test time will be arranged closer to the time, because what happened is that 1st of September was a general date that NAATI selected. Okay, initially when NAATI went online, and many people have actually booked that, but they don't have the capacity to conduct tests for so many people on a particular date. So what they are doing is they have just given a general date, and now depending upon the availability, they are giving you an option of choosing two to three range of dates, okay, for your exam. So I would recommend you, and you are supposed to do that within 24 hours of receiving the email. So I encourage you to check your email box frequently, and if you're getting any such email, just verify the address who is sending you. If it is naati.com.au, then please reply to that saying after choosing a date, whatever you are comfortable with. And don't think that, okay, it may happen that not everyone receives it, but if you are receiving it, you need to take an action within 24 hours. If you don't do it, then they're going to cancel your exam, which you don't want it to happen. And then you have to follow up with them. And if they accommodate that, then only they will give you a different date, or they will just going to refund you the money. and again you need to go through the process of rebooking the exam. So of course you cannot take any chances here. Just reply to that email choosing a particular range of date, and then you will be receiving a final invite or final test date from them saying that this is your test date, final test date, and this is the link to connect to the exam. So not everyone will receive it, but if you receive it, then kindly do reply within 24 hours. Okay, otherwise your test might be cancelled and you don't want that to happen because you have already been waiting for a long time. So it doesn't make sense not to reply, okay, and then just have your exam cancelled, because then again you need to rebook it. So thank you guys. So these were the 10 questions that I thought that okay makes sense for it to be answered through a centralized place. So I uploaded it as a video so that you need not wait for my reply if you post any questions. And even if you may not have these questions now at a particular time, you might have it. So then you need not post your questions to my email box or to our Telegram group. You will have it answered here itself, okay? And it will give you some clarity about the exam before going for it. Okay, there are many such interesting videos which you can find on my channel, and I will encourage you to go through it because it will just make you more prepared for the exam. Okay, there is also another video on how the NAATI online test is conducted. So if you follow that, it will enable you to be ready before going for the exam. So I highly recommend that you watch that video before going for it because it will give you a good feel. And I also urge people to kindly join the Telegram group because many people are getting benefited out of it. I have not been posting success stories very often, but more than 200 people have already cleared the exam and everything is free over there. You don't need to pay for anything. We are doing everything from our side to help people and we don't charge anything. Okay, it is completely a free service. We believe the NAATI community is growing and we should be setting some standards, or we should be coming forward to help all the fellow aspirants and for once think above money and just genuinely help the community. So this is what I believe in, and this is what the people who are associated with me believes in. So we believe that okay, already people are spending a lot, and during this pandemic situation, just making them pay for something else, just by making them fear about the exam, it's not human. Okay, it's something which I don't believe in, and I don't encourage others also to do it because it just adds on to the pressure. So whatever we can during this pandemic situation, we are going to do to help everyone, and we will continue this service for as long as we can. Okay, so I would highly recommend you to join this Telegram group if you want a free service. Okay, you absolutely don't have to pay for anything. If anyone asks you to pay, no one will ask you actually. And even if someone asks you, saying you just call me directly, or you drop me a message saying that okay, so and so person is asking. No one is supposed to ask you for any money whatsoever. It is completely free, and I would encourage you to join that and get the maximum benefit out of it because many people are getting it. The link of it you can find in the video description. Okay, anything else that you need my help for, kindly drop me an email, you have it, or kindly join the Telegram group and post a message over there. I will shortly reply, and there are other people who are very active and they will give you a reply and try to help you in every possible way. Okay, this is the least that I can do from my side, especially during the situation situation that we are facing, and I felt that okay, it has to be done by someone. So I'm just doing it. I'm very hopeful that many people will come forward and they will do it. And in this way, we can actually build a stronger community and a much helping one. So thank you so much for this video. Okay. Be safe. Okay. Stay at home. Don't go outside until unless it is very necessary. I would recommend you to buy everything online. Okay. Don't worry about the quality. Quality is good everywhere. So please don't step outside until unless it is very much required. Okay, be safe and be with your family. Okay, support them in every way possible. Now is the time where even you need their support and even they need yours. So be very supportive and be there for your family, and just enjoy the journey no matter what you are doing. Okay, just try to enjoy it, because only if you enjoy it, you're not going to feel the pain, or you're not going to feel the pressure of it. You are just going to, be happy that, okay, you are doing something for the betterment of your family. So just stick to it and have a goal and just follow that. Follow your dreams. Okay. This is what I want everyone to do it. Okay, thank you so much, guys. If you like the content, kindly give a thumbs up. That will be very encouraging for me. Also, if possible, kindly drop your comments in the comment section. I love to read them all. And if there is any feedback on how I can improve, of course I do that. I know sometimes the video gets very longer, but I just want to connect with you in the best possible way. Genuinely tell you whatever I'm feeling. I don't follow any script, and I just say everything out of whatever is there in my heart. Okay, that is how I am, and that is how I believe everyone should be. There should not be any limit in terms of words. Okay, thank you so much, guys. Have a nice day. Bye bye.